shape is the important beginning, because I want a dog to use its eyes and its nose, and I want it to be about equal. If the dog can't, if all we do is we're focused on nose work, as soon as the dog is not downwind of it, they're not gonna be able to smell it. So I want them to be able to visually pick up on the idea of, ooh, there's one of those things. Now, when they can't see it, which is the majority of the time when there's cover, I want a dog to have certain scent clues that tip it off to say, I should go look at that closer. So this scent, I've got different ingredients. I make this myself. I've got different ingredients in there that are scent clues to an antler. And an antler is a bone, but an antler also, if you find fresh sheds, look at these. Look at the pedicle. There's always hair right at the base. There's always this, they call it a wax ring, but it's this substance that is part of that fusion to the head. I've found a lot of them that have this green, snot-like looking substance. And it, for us, like I don't know that I would smell it, but if you want to know how strong an antler, because a lot of people go, oh, the antlers don't have much scent. They've got a lot of scent. Take a Tupperware tub, take a bunch of fresh sheds, put it in a sealed Tupperware tub and put the lid on it, and then put it in your pickup truck in the sun and let it get hot. And then open that lid and take a whiff. It'll about knock you over. And the reason is because it's concentrated. Like there's a lot of odor particles there and it hits you quick and you'll smell it. But I take a lot of those scent clues and I put it into this. Now, I'm gonna give you a secret. So one of the things that's a part of this that people just don't think about, because the idea of antler is, oh, it's an antler, it's a bone. Yes, it is, and bones have scent. And as bones get older, the scent changes. So like cadaver dogs, dogs that find dead bodies, they'll find bodies that were buried years and years and years and years ago, that smells different as it ages. And these dogs, it's like a tracking dog. That guy just left, he was a tracking guy. We were talking about it earlier. I said, when we were at our booth, I said, I mean, think about the dog's nose. If a deer ran through this room, it would take them not very long to get from there to there. Like we're talking less than a second. It's right now, a deer runs through. Let's say a deer got shot and he runs through the room. He can cover a lot of ground really quickly. The scent right there versus the scent right there where he left the room smells different to the dog. One of them's older than the other. That scent is older than that scent. That's how a dog determines direction on scent. Like it can tell that that's older than that. So what does that mean? Well, he's going that way. That's how tracking dogs process. So can you imagine the ability to calculate that stuff that quickly in the instant that they're working? And then all of a sudden think about a deer that backtracks. That's older scent than that. But now all of a sudden their scent too, that's fresher than that, but it's, they have to sift through all of that stuff like in a split second in order to make the right decision. That's where they can get kind of tangled up and they can start to rework tracks, and you just watch them. You just let them, just shut up and let them do their thing.